There's a new book on the way about the Trump family written by somebody who's actually a member of the Trump family. It's written by Fred Trump III, who, of course, is the son of Fred Trump Jr., who is the eldest son of the patriarch of the family, Fred Trump. So he is Donald Trump's nephew, and he's got a new book titled All in the Family, The Trumps and How We Got This Way. It's a good title, right? But anyway, in this book, Fred Trump III tells the story of how around March of 2020, right as the COVID pandemic's blowing up here in the United States, he went to a meeting with the White House because, you know, his uncle was the president. They still got along. And he was there with this meeting with health officials and, you know, the Health and Human Services czar, Alex Azar, because he's a disability rights advocate. So he was there with a couple other disability rights advocates to talk about the plight of disabled people and people with compromised immune systems and how they were more susceptible to COVID and how we needed to protect them. Now, according to what he wrote in the book, after the big meeting with everybody ended, pardon me, he then gets called by his uncle like, hey, come over to the Oval Office. Let's sit and chit chat. And it was during this non-meeting chit chat that Fred Trump III says that his uncle Donald Trump said this. Those people, the shape they're in, all the expenses, maybe those kinds of people should just die. Talking, of course, about people with disabilities or compromised immune systems who happen to catch COVID. Maybe those kinds of people should just die. Now, that is according to Fred Trump. That is what his uncle said off the record. We do not have any way to verify whether or not that actually happened. So we cannot say for certain that it did. What we can say is that based on Donald Trump's past behavior, like when he mocked the reporter with disabilities, Sergey Kovaleski was his name. We do know that Donald Trump seems to have disdain for people with disabilities. He has no respect for them. He openly mocks them. So does this seem like something Donald Trump would say? 100%. Kind of like the Access Hollywood tape, right? When he thinks nobody's around that's going to say anything about it, he's going to let his real thoughts on something fly. And I do believe that that is what happened here. Now, of course, again, I cannot prove that Donald Trump said this, but I can't prove he didn't either. And given Donald Trump's history, it absolutely falls in line with something that Donald Trump would say. And I don't even need to sit here and go preachy on you and tell you how horrible this is and how disturbing it is. You know that. You get that. But I do want everybody to remember that according to his own nephew, Donald Trump said that people with disabilities should just die. Because, you got to catch this part in that statement too, they're just too expensive. Why would we want to spend money to keep somebody like that alive? Now ask yourself, is that the guy you want in the White House? Is that the guy you want in charge of health decisions for the entire nation? Probably not. Because I'm willing to bet, just like he doesn't value the lives of disabled people, everybody watching this, and myself included, he doesn't put a value on our lives either. We are just as expendable as those other people that he says shouldn't be kept alive. It's not just about people with disabilities. It's about anybody that he feels is beneath him in his status, okay? That's all of us. None of us are worth keeping alive to Donald Trump. America's Lawyer has launched its own YouTube channel. Now, this channel, of course, is still in its early phases of development, but you can help grow it by subscribing. Just go to youtube.com/TheAmericasLawyer, and you'll get all of the great content from Mike Papantonio and myself that we produce every single week.